Tonight from AT&T Stadium, it's a District 4 6A matchup as the Martin Warriors take on the Fort Worth Paschal Panthers. And good evening, everyone. John Nelson, our AISD-TV production crew, and a first for AISD-TV on hand for Martin's homecoming, which happens to be this year at AT&T Stadium. Martin comes in with a record of 4-0, leading District 4 6A. Paschal at 1-3. Martin coming off a 33-21 win last week over Bowie. And Paschal dismantled by Sam Houston to the tune of 75-19. Martin, the home team tonight, comes in averaging 42 points a game, giving up 28. They opened the year no loss in a shame, losing to the Eagles of DeSoto. Week two, Martin losing to Skyline. No shame there. And then from that point, they have reeled off five consecutive wins and really the team to beat in District 4-6A. Lamar in second place at 3-1. And then Sam Houston, Bowie, North Crowley, and Arlington all at 2-2 in district play. Martin in their home black with silver helmets, and the visiting Paschal Panthers in road white with purple trim and silver helmets. Paschal comes in averaging 31 points a game, but they give up a whopping 56. Martin and Paschal down through the years have played in six different stadiums. The series started back in 1994 at Texas Stadium. Martin won that first game 36-8. And the referee in the sunlight indicating that Fort Worth Paschal has won the toss. They will receive and defend the goal to our right. AT&T Stadium runs east to west, and the low setting sun, which right about now presenting itself quite a glare through the western skylight. Martin down through the years 2-2 at AT&T Stadium. They won last year at Craven 66-20. Head coach Bob Wager in his ninth year. There he is. 129 wins, 74 losses. Paschal guided by Matt Cook in his eighth year. Took over for Mike Norwood. 31 seniors, 20 juniors, and 6 sophomores for Fort Worth Paschal, one of the oldest schools in Fort Worth. And Martin with 31 seniors as well. We break and back with a kickoff tonight from AT&T Stadium right after this. Trey Turtle has it teed up for the Martin Warriors. And the senior set to get week 8 underway. It's deep and sails over the shoulder of Kelly DeRoe and will down it and will come out to the 25-yard line. Both kickers, Trey Tuttle and Julio Martinez, had no trouble hitting field goals from 45 yards in their pregame warmups. Julian Martinez, a senior as well as Trey Tuttle. First and 10, Paschal. They come in averaging 180 yards of rushing and 31 points on the board. Now the Martin defense switched to a three-man front. They're anchored by O'Shea Jackson and nose guard D.D. Fletcher. Jackson has committed to Colorado State. Martin giving up just 28 points a game. The signal caller, Dylan Thomas, the junior. First and 10, Paschal at their own 25. And they send four receivers to the near side. Kalen Geiger has 28 catches this year for Paschal. Number 3 in motion is Chris Pardrone, and a flag as the Panthers may have started towards a line of scrimmage. You can run sideways, but not towards a line of scrimmage, but that's not the case. It's a timeout. So the Panthers, before the first play, take a timeout. Martin has won 5 in a row. Again, having started off at 0-2. The defensive line for the Warriors averages right at 240 pounds. So Paschal has already burned a timeout. And they'll reset it. Offensive center is set to go. And we'll do it all over again. Dylan Thomas, one of the inside receivers, again taking off his Padron number 26. As Thomas scrambles, looking, in troubles, now runs against the grain. He's got 5, 10, 15, mark it off at 17 yards. Dylan Thomas, and a first down for Paschal. He makes a miss. Everyone covered to the right as Thomas took off. Picks up a quick 13 yards. Or 17 yards, rather.
First and 10, Panthers.
From the 43, from the spread formation, Thomas looking near side, throws over the middle, caught in traffic, crossing midfield is David Hernandez. Hernandez, one of 31 seniors, his 23rd catch of the year. And another first down for Paschal. Hernandez has a couple of touchdown catches this year.
McQuaylen Thomas on the tackle. First and 10, Panthers.
Thomas making the tackle for Martin. DeQuaylen Thomas, number 16. And stacked up in midfield, Thomas loses yardage.
Number 44,
D.D. Fletcher, a 6'1", 230-pound senior. Gumming up the works for Martin. It'll be second down and about 12. Inside receivers, Kelly Giroux, number 5. Twin receivers to the near side for Dylan Thomas. Thomas comes in completing 45% of his passes, 638 yards. Scrambles again. Thomas, about 2, wrapped up at the Martin 46-yard line. Number 34, O'Shea Jackson at 6 feet and 275. And again, has committed to Colorado State. It'll be third down and needing about 9. With Thomas, running back Chris Padron. Now Padron moves to the right on third and 9. Thomas, and Thomas leveled at the 44. Another tackle for DeQuaylen Thomas, as 48 tackles make it 49 this year. And it'll be fourth and long, and William Floyd and the special teams come on. Here's another look at Thomas. Wanted to go over the middle, and then a nice waist-high takedown by Martin's DeQuaylen Thomas. Fourth and 20. It was a loss of 11. Number 12, Trip White.
William Floyd.
Back in return posture. William Floyd in punt formation now runs and unloads on the run. It's a wobbler and goes out of bounds near the Martin 30-yard line. So Paschal forced to punt on his first possession as they mark off the angle. They'll mark it at the Martin 28-yard line. Quarterback situation this year for Martin changed dramatically when starter Eric Walker broke his ankle October 3rd in the first quarter against Sam Houston. Senior Noah Bondrett and sophomore Trey Brown replaced Walker the rest of the game. Martin won that contest 40-20. But Tyler Wilson will see action. Linebacker Josh Watson has been used this year in goal line situations.
Number 22, Trey Brown.
And the sophomore Trey Brown will keep it. Brown crosses a 30, crosses a 35, breaks a tackle down the rail. 30, 20, 72 yards on Martin's first play, no flags. Trey Brown breaking tackles, staying in bounds, and Martin is on the board. 72 yards.
71
yards. It is 6-0 Martin. Trey Prophet.
Josh Watson holding.
A senior. And a drop kick. How about this? Prophet with a drop kick. It is good. Haven't seen that since the 1940s. A flag down. I thought something was askew when Martinez or Tuttle did not come on. There was no tee. And I looked out and saw number 20, Trey Prophet. He's the punter, and a drop kick if the penalty is against Paschal.
Running into the kicker on the defense.
That's got to be a strange sight for the defense. Running into the kicker is the call, and the extra point is good, and Martin leads 7-0. So a drop kick.
It's good. 6-1 for the
Warriors. With 8:52 to go. In the first quarter. Here's another look at it. Well, here's the touchdown run first by Trey Brown. Brown gets away from number 29. He sheds a Marino, Ulysses Marino, and takes it the rest of the way. Daniel Rodriguez giving chase. But Brown has tonight's first touchdown, and then Prophet's drop kick on the extra point. Trey Tuttle will kick off again.
Trey Tuttle kicking off for the Warriors.
Back deep, Kelly Duro, number 5, and joined by Chris Padron. Well, how about that? A 72-yard run and a drop kick. And this one heads toward Kelly Duro, fumbles at the 8, picks it up on the 9, and goes down at the 11.
Duro, number 5, picking up at the 5.
Nice pursuit downfield for Martin. Christian Levy down there, number 2, and about 3 or 4 others. Garrett Bales, number 24.
Number 2, Christian Levy on the tackle for the Warriors.
Second possession for Paschal. Trailing 7-0. Defensively, Martin allowing 156 yards of rushing and 218 yards of passing. Paschal averages more than 200 yards of passing a game. But their trouble this year is on defense. They just can't hold anybody. At the 17. Dylan Thomas fires low, and that's Kalen Geiger. Geiger with his 29th catch. It'll be second down and about 3. Handoff in the middle, breaking tackles, crossing the 35, the 40 to midfield. Is Padron, Chris Padron.
On the carry was number 26, Chris Padron.
They'll spot it at the Martin 49-yard line. 40-plus yards as Padron gets around Nick Albus. Trying to knock Padron loose of the ball, but he's out of bounds at that point. Also evaded number 11, Jordan Trim. As we come back to play, Geiger with a catch at the Martin 34.
That's a 15-yard pickup and a first down.
So a pickup of 15 yards. First and 10, Paschal, they scrimmage at the Warrior 34. Paschal averaging 31 points a contest. Martin giving up less than that. At the 34 and first down, twin receivers to the short side. Thomas scrambles, runs, penalty marker dropped in the backfield. Finally upset by Jordan Trim. And we'll check out the penalty. Thomas had a good year last season as a sophomore for Paschal. Now the team last year finished 5-5. The penalty is an illegal cut block. There's also a holding penalty. So it'll be 15 yards from the spot of the foul. Paschal in district play last year went 2-5. Overall, a 500 team. Martin went 10-3 last year. Finished second to Lamar in the district at 5-1. They beat Keller Central, they beat Odessa, then lost to DeSoto in round three. The penalty yardage places it back at the Martin 49. It's first down and 25. Thomas cuts it back and is spun down at the 45. Jimmy Nelson, number 88, there for Martin.
On the tackle was number 88, Jimmy Nelson, a junior right end.
See Nelson just bending back. Jimmy at 6'1 and 215 pounds, one of 15 juniors for Coach Bob Wager. It's second down and 30. That's a loss of five from the 46. Thomas again has to scramble and meets number 44 in the hole, D.D. Fletcher. Over the top, DeQuaylen Thomas, number 16. Paschal keeps moving in the wrong direction. More loss of yardage. It's spotted at the 40. It's a loss of six. It'll be third and a mile. Third down in the field from the Panther 40. Thomas hands off on the draw to Padron. Finds daylight, crosses midfield. Padron tackled at the 45. Josh Watson there to catch up with Padron. Watson led Martin in tackles last year with 141. Enters tonight's game with 64 stops. That was a gain of 14. It'll be fourth and 22. Still fourth and long. Martin anticipating punt as number 12, Trip White, drops back. William Floyd. Runs. A wobbler again and goes out of bounds. He will have done his job if they can pin him back inside the 15-yard line. Martin leading 7-0 with 5:17 to go in the liftoff period here at AT&T Stadium. There's a look at the Warrior Nation homecoming tonight for MHS. Going to mark it out at the 12-yard line. So it was a nice punt by William Floyd, a senior. Second possession for Martin. Chance to kind of set the offense following Trey Brown's 72-yard run. There's Brown, number 22. The running back is Nick Smith. Nick is third in the area in scoring, has over 700 yards. And here's Smith coming right and buried at the 13. Not much. Cruz Chopay, number 21, on the stop. They'll give him 2 yards. It'll be second down 8. Wide left, Tyler Wilson, number 17. Quarterback, sophomore Trey Brown. On the draw to Nick Smith, up the middle, 20. 25, finds a crevice, 45. One man to beat, gets a block at midfield, and Nick Smith will take it 86 yards. It's been a first quarter of big plays for Martin. His longest run of the year, his 19th touchdown. Junior Nick Smith comes in averaging 7 yards a carry. It is 13-0. And again, we may see the drop kick. Not Trey Tuttle. The tee is out. Tuttle out of the hold of Josh Watson will try to make it 14-0 Martin. It is up. It is true and through. A little over 4 minutes from their last score. Martin makes it 14-0. Nick Smith, again, third in the area in rushing. Gets a nice block from number 75, Leonard Bradley. And downfield, you see the wipeout block by Levy, number two. And Nick Smith has nothing but white stripes and green turf in front of him. Martin going for its second 5-0 district start in 3 years. And they look good tonight early. On top, 14-love. Paschal giving up 56 points a game this year. Gave up 75 to the Texans of Sam last week. Trey Tuttle. Kickoff for the third time. That low setting sun, if you're moving to the west, could pose a problem for the next 35 minutes or so. This one's going to go out of bounds. Kelly DeRoe wasn't going to have anything to do with that. As the kick goes out of bounds, and Paschal will have it for the third time this period. So you give up yardage when it goes out of bounds. They start from the 30. Dylan Thomas. Tandem yardage this year for Paschal. He has over 1,300 yards running and passing. Has thrown for six touchdowns, has also run for six. And as a receiver, has caught three touchdown passes. Paschal trailing 14-0. Thomas comes out throwing. It is almost intercepted at the 34. Number six, Nick Albus. Knocked it loose, intended for Geiger, number three. And Geiger looking right back into the sun. There's Coach Bob Wager. 129 wins. Doesn't seem like he's been at Martin now for 9 years, but he has. To the 33-yard line, and maybe a couple of more yards.
Geiger, reception is good.
Kalen Geiger. They'll give him the 35. It'll be third down and five. Clock moving, 4:09 left in the first quarter. Two receivers on either side. The setback is Padron, number 26. Thomas looking over the middle. And Thomas sandwiched at the 27. We see more pileups than Talladega here in the first quarter. Thomas again wrapped up behind the line of scrimmage. And it'll bring up fourth down for Paschal. They'll punt for the third consecutive possession. Trip White standing in the sunlight near midfield. William Floyd standing about 9 yards behind the center. He'll throw over the middle, wide open, 45 to midfield, to the Martin 40. It's fumbled. It's still loose, and Martin picks it up. They had the first down. Trip White falls on it, at the Martin 25. Well, good news, bad news for Paschal. Good news, Martin had no clue over the middle. And the receiver wide open, big yardage, only to lose it. So Martin takes over at its own 25. Here's another look, Padron, and then was sideswiped by Murray. And here's Martin at its own 25, first and 10. Brown throws on the run, caught at the 40, 45. This is Tyler Wilson. Wilson all the way down to the Paschal 37 or so. Is he? I stayed in bounds. They'll give him the 28-yard line. That is Martin's first down. At the 29, that's where they spotted. 2:46 to go. That was a gain of close to 50 yards. Tyler Wilson, catch number 21 on the year. Running play to the right. Nick Smith trying to stay in bounds and goes out near the 15. It'll be first and goal, Martin. Got a nice block at about the 25. Here's the toss to Smith. Cuts it back. 10, 5, touchdown. Nick Smith, his second.
Off the handoff, that's number 21, Nick Smith. Inside, touchdown.
A 15-yard run. It is 20 to nothing. A 75-yard drive. Trey Tuttle out of the hole of Josh Watson. Now they run up in a two-point conversion formation, perhaps. Yeah, they're gonna go for two. Here's a flip handoff. And then the pass, and wide open in the end zone, caught for the two-point conversion. Number 92, Trey Tuttle. Two-point conversion. They have drop-kicked one. They have had the conventional extra-point kick, and now the two-point conversion. Number 82, Jess Trussell. And then Trey Tuttle near the back of the end zone. They have converted every conceivable way on extra points here in the first quarter. Let's go back and look at Nick Smith's 15-yard run. Just evading everyone, no one laid a hand on him. Alfredo Flores, number 54, overran Smith at about the 10. And a 22-0 Martin lead. Just a tough season and a tough go tonight for the Paschal Panthers. They have had some injuries. And the kick by Tuttle. And goes out of bounds over the shoulder of Kelly Durow at the 4-yard line. He'll come out to the 30 again.
Procedure penalty on the kick team. Kicking the ball out of bounds.
The penalty, illegal procedure, and will be spotted at the 30. So Paschal's fourth possession. Dylan Thomas up to the line of scrimmage, has running backs now to either side. And the handoff, 30, out to the 31-yard line. A hard gain of a yard. Chris Padron on the handoff and taken down by number 44, D.D. Fletcher. Fletcher didn't have to give much ground. DeMarcus Bowers also there, the linebacker number 9. It'll be second down 9. Hunter Williamson, one of the inside receivers here on 2nd and 9. Geiger is to the near side. There's Thomas. Play clock down to 6. On 2nd and 9, they do get it off. On the sweep and buried is DeRoe. DeRoe level by Jordan Trim, number 11. Here's a handoff, and as soon as DeRoe tries to look for an opening from the backside is Trim. It's a loss of 5. It'll be 3rd and 14. Handoff, or rather trying to hand it off, was Thomas. And then Thomas draws a crowd at the 20. DeQuaylon Thomas and 3 other black shirts all over the Paschal quarterback. Trim there as well. So Paschal started at the 30. The ball at the 22. They lose 8 yards on this possession. Martin takes over at the 22. Looking, throwing, and caught at the 15-yard line. Number 2, Levy. About 7 yards on the gain. Brown comes in with a 42% completion rate, 109 yards. But Eric Walker out for the year, the season's starting quarterback. Gain of 6, 2nd down 4. Ball to the Paschal 15-yard line. Inside of a half a minute. Brown wants to throw, will keep it. Still on his feet, breaks a tackle, sheds another one near the goal line and scores. Trey Brown. His second running touchdown. It is 28-0. Travis Murray with a nice block near the sidelines. And another 2-point conversion try and successful. Number 87, Larry Gibson. And that ups the ante to an even 30. 4 touchdowns here in the first quarter. Here's Trey Brown's second score of the night. Wants to throw. Evades number 25, Noah Viacana. Jumps over 19 at the goal line, Jack Claunch. And Brown, for the second time, finds the end zone. 30-0. The Martin Warriors here on homecoming night. And then the 2-point conversion just to run over the right side. And an easy score for Larry Gibson. Trey Tuttle has been busy, and that's what a kicker likes. You want to have a lot of kickoffs, which means your team is doing quite well. This one caught at the 4. This is Kelly Durow, 15, and wrestled down hard at the 15-yard line. Like Jordan Hughes downfield. Got 28 rather. Carl Wilson. Wilson. Hughes wears 26. Wilson wears 28.
Carl Wilson on the tackle for the Warriors.
And Paschal sets up shop at the 14-yard line. Martin piled up over 300 yards of rushing last week in the win over Bowie. Caught in traffic at the 16 and working his way out to the 17-yard line is Kalen Geiger, and that's the end of the first quarter. Completion for Dylan Thomas.
Nick Albus on the stop for the Warriors.
As the two teams will swap ends, and that is the end of the first quarter at AT&T Stadium. Our score, the Martin Warriors 30, the Paschal Panthers nothing.
And at the end of the first quarter, Martin High School Warriors 30.
First play of the second quarter, Paschal has it at their own 18-yard line, trailing 30 to nothing. It is second down and 6 for quarterback Dylan Thomas. As a receiver to the left side, it's up for grabs and batted loose at the 40-yard line. Pass intended for Geiger. And Martin defending quite well. Number 30, there to knock it down, Bradrick McEwen.
Excellent defense by Martin.
Anthony Hargrove is with us, and Anthony, if there is any kind of a penalty situation or, well, anything really, you're a referee. You've seen many, many calls, and your expertise may be called upon tonight just for that. Loss of yardage all the way back to the 8. Thomas just getting no help at all. And another quarterback trap, Josh Watson, the center fielder on the baseball team. All district last year, making the stop, came in with 64 tackles. And another fourth down situation for Paschal. It's 4th and 15.
William Floyd back to punt.
Zach Sitton getting on the special teams. Paschal getting everyone set. William Floyd will stand at the goal line.
Should be a false start.
Had some motion.
Dead ball. Delay game. Oh, holding off. Half the distance.
That's half the distance. We'll put it inside the 5. So Paschal doing itself no favors and punting from the end zone is Floyd. Parker DeBose will block. Trip White back deep for Martin. Over his head, picked up. Tries to kick it. He does. Caught at the 10-yard line and a touchdown. It ends up in the hands of Josh Watson.
Wow.
Floyd had to run for his life. Anthony finally was able to find a path and get the kick off. It was end over end, and then Watson caught it on the line drive and scores.
10-yard punt return, Josh Watson.
How many different ways can they score tonight? It is 36 to nothing. Trey Tuttle try to convert on his 12th extra point of the year and drives it through.
It's good.
37 to nothing.
10:44 left in the first half. 37 to nothing.
Look back at Floyd. It stays in bounds. Sideways gets rid of it, and then Watson has it gift wrapped. An early Christmas present as he takes it in from 10 yards out. That was bad enough. You have to scramble and try to get the punt off.
Right.
He did. Unfortunately, it stayed low. And Watson was there to pick it off.
I don't know if it would have been better for him to take the safety and then to just give up a touchdown like that. I'm not sure.
I think at that point, if you've ever been in that situation, it may be the first time he's been in that situation this year, and just the adrenaline took over and your first impulse, I better get rid of it.
Yeah.
So it is all Martin in cruise control here in the first half, coming in averaging 42 points a game.
Paschal has to get something going on this drive.
And he has to convert a couple of first downs. Julian Martinez and a spinner caught on the run at the 28 and bombed at the 30. Trip White downfield for Martin. And the sixth possession for the Paschal Panthers.
Christian Aquavico, Aquavicio, receiving for the Panthers. First and 10, Paschal.
Paschal came in with 180 yards of rushing a game, but Martin unofficially with six quarterback traps in the first half so far. From the 30, junior Dylan Thomas. Low snap, picks it up, in trouble, and goes down at the 23.
The center has to get a better snap on.
Thomas out the shotgun. DD touchy, and on the stop.
Loss of 7, second and 17.
Second down and 17.
Yeah, you're right. Anytime you have to bend over, pick up a low snap, you lose a couple of seconds to the lineman rushing right at you. Mm. Second and 17. Thomas has it cocked over the middle and deflected at the 36-yard line. Pass intended for David Hernandez, number 10.
Pass intended for number 10, David Hernandez.
DeQuellen Thomas had a fingertip on it.
Third down.
Third and 17 for Paschal. And again, they'll send three receivers to the short side. Among them, Hunter Williamson, number 6. Now Kelly DeRoe is moved over as a wingback on the left. Padron, the running back.
Oh, okay.
Thomas scrambles, and that's been the M.O. He goes down at the line of scrimmage. And fourth down, another fourth down for Paschal as William Floyd, the punter, comes on. 37-0 Martin.
Paschal got nothing on that drive. They only went backwards.
From the 18, a little better snap. Here's the pressure, end over end. Caught at the 45-yard line, 35, 30, 20, 15. Only the punter to beat if he can stay in bounds and tiptoes out of bounds. Number 12, Trip White, went out at about the 10-yard line.
Inside the 20, inside the 15, out of bounds at the 10-yard line.
And they do mark him out at the 10. Here's White. Well, the nice cut here, a head fake on the punter, and loses his balance at about the 10.
Nice save and tackle by the punter.
It is right on the 10. It is first and goal. Tyler Wilson is the quarterback. And here's the pitch to Nick Smith. Five, goal line, untouched. Didn't need an escort at all.
Nick Smith on the right side.
Nick Smith on the toss from the new quarterback, Tyler Wilson. His third touchdown.
Defense was totally out of position on that play.
Miles Kelly in the backfield as Bob Wager getting some new personnel in offensively on that series. Josh Watson. Be the holder for Trey Tuttle. Extra points is perfect. And Martin now leads 44 to nothing. A short 10-yard drive. Nick Smith with three touchdowns. Trey Brown with two. And a blocked punt taken for a touchdown by Josh Watson. There's the Martin band. You'll see the halftime performance of the Martin band. Lower section beginning to fill up at AT&T Stadium. Martin, again, it's her homecoming. This Martin Paschal series has seen games at Texas Stadium, Clark Stadium, Farrington Field, Hanley Stadium, Cravens, and now AT&T Stadium. .903 to go in the first half, and a long night for head coach Matt Cook. His eighth year at the helm.
Number 93, Alan Castolinia, kicking off for the Warriors.
Martin had 20 first downs and 346 yards of rushing last week in the win over Bowie. And the straight-on kickoff, end over end, caught at the 16-yard line, 25 out to the 27-yard line, Kelly DeRoe. And that's where they will mark him. And the seventh possession for Paschal. And again, Anthony, a couple of first downs. Just hold on to the ball, try to find any kind of running room at all. They've been successful to Geiger on some passes, but you can't live by that all night.
No.
David Hernandez, one of the two receivers wide right.
Well, there we go. Paschal's getting some yards.
Late flag, a hold on the kickoff against Martin. Okay, that'll place it at the 37. At the 37, first and 10, Paschal. Thomas, the QB, and here's Padron, number 26. Thomas, over the middle, caught and dropped at the 36. Hunter Williamson on a drag.
Thomas on the shotgun.
On the stop, number three, Jared Phipps, a senior.
Jared Phipps in on the stop for the Warriors.
Gain of a yard at the most. Second down and a long nine with 8:27 to go in the half. In motion, Hernandez. Thomas rolls to the near side, throws, caught! And a first down crossing midfield. Nice catch by Hunter Williamson. He has two touchdown catches this year. and Paschal's second big play. They had a fourth down fake punt that resulted in big yardage, but they eventually fumbled. And the second big gain tonight for Paschal. First and 10 Panthers at the mark and 42. Draw play. Padron, penalty marker dropped.
That's going to be a hold on Paschal.
Not much room at all for Padron. And
holding. 66 in the offense.
It is a hold.
That just totally killed the momentum.
So for the point of the foul, which really was at the line of scrimmage, it'll place it at the 48. From their own 48, Thomas looking, throws deep, left side, has a man open, caught! 15, 10, 5, touchdown! Kalen Geiger, 52 yards.
Now the shotgun, Thomas, to number 3, Kalen Geiger, touchdown! Panthers!
And Paschal will not be shut out tonight. 52 yards, Thomas loading up. And Geiger got behind number 8, Brandon Dillard.
Martin had no help over the top. It was one-on-one play. That was all speed by Paschal.
Number 9, Christian Vasquez, has been successful on 15 extra points this year. They need another man, Garrison Gandy, on the line of scrimmage. Need another blocker. William Floyd will hold. Vasquez on the PAT. It is up. And it is good.
It's good.
It is 44-7. Paschal able to get the touchdown with 7:32 to go in the half.
50-yard touchdown pass for Dylan Thomas.
For Thomas, his seventh touchdown pass of the year. Geiger, his third touchdown catch.
Let's see if that touchdown can give the defense a spark here and come away with a three and out.
Martin opened up district play, defeating Lamar 67-20. And again, they are perfect in district at 4-0. There's the largest video display board in the world, 160 feet long. It's 90 feet above the stadium floor. And you can't help but look up about 50% of the time. You could fit the Statue of Liberty inside AT&T Stadium, and it's that tall. 44-7, our new score. Number 9, Christian Vasquez, set to kick off. And drives it to the 4-yard line. 10, 15, this is Phipps. 25, 30, 35, Jared Phipps. Down the rail, he's in bounds. Phipps.
No, he's out.
Is he out of bounds?
He's out.
One of the referees said okay, the other said, it's gonna be out near the 30-yard line.
Jared Phipps on the carry. Trying to get it to the house.
66 yards nonetheless. He got by the first way, broke a tackle at about the 15. Trying to stay in bounds and is bumped out of bounds by DeRoe.
First and 10 Warriors inside Panthers
They spot it at the 32. And the quarterback will be Tyler Wilson, a junior. Wilson from the shotgun, hands off on the sweep. 25, 20, 15, that's Jason Huntley. Huntley with a first down.
Levy heading off to number 15, that was Jason Huntley on the carry.
17 yards on the pickup.
Gain of about 19 on the play. First and 10, Warriors.
Under 7 minutes remaining in the first half. Sideline left, open field right for Tyler Wilson. Here's Nick Smith in motion. And the handoff running outside the numbers to the 10, to the 5, trying to cut it back and stay in bounds is Wilson. And Wilson takes it to the 1.
Tyler Wilson on the carry.
It's first and goal. Got the handoff from Trey Brown.
Number 12, that was Jonathan Carrillo for the Panthers.
So Wilson.
It's going to be a first and goal.
Almost got it in there. Jonathan Carrillo with a tackle. First and goal marking.
T minus 6 and 17 left in the first half.
Behind center, Alex Samshom. I formation. The fullback is Kelly. Miles Kelly. Here's the toss to the goal line.
Wilson on the pick.
To the end zone.
Smith on the carry.
Nick Smith. And Martin has another score.
Nice little inside run by Nick Smith. Followed his blockers. Easy touchdown.
A 1 yard run. His fourth TD of the first half. And Martin has hit a half a hundred.
Julian Martinez back for the extra point.
Julian Martinez. Just 4 years ago at Young Junior High with a game-winning field goal in the 8th grade city championship. Extra point is good. Our new score with 5:58 to go in the half. Martin 51, Paschal 7. They can just about name their score tonight. And a big treat for everyone to come to AT&T Stadium in late October. Paschal's first game ever at AT&T Stadium. Martin winning big at Cravens last year, 66-20. In 2009, the first game played here at Cowboys Stadium. Exhibition game between the Cowboys and the Tennessee Titans. First regular season game on a Monday night. And the New York Giants spoiled the party in 2009. So Martin set to kick off.
Trey Proffitt set the kickoff for the Warriors.
And Trey Proffitt with a squib kick. It's fielded at the 26, number 7, Gil Lee.
Gil Lee, the young man.
It's going to be a flag, dead ball, foul.
Dropped it about midfield. One of the penalty markers, Anthony, all the way back at the 50-yard line.
Looked like some activity after the whistle blew.
Referee will give us the call here with 5:52 to go in the half.
Probably going to be a personal foul on Martin.
Holding. 45 with the return team. 10-yard penalty from the end of the run. First down.
Wow. So a hold on the kickoff return on Paschal. They have placed the ball at the 20. And that's where they will start. This is the eighth possession in the first half for Paschal.
See if Paschal can continue to drive ahead on the last series.
Dylan Thomas loading up right side, has the receiver Geiger, intercepted at midfield. Nick Albus, his third interception of the year. Thomas trying to go deep. And the senior cornerback turned at the right time. He played the ball, and what you're supposed to do. You don't play the man, you play the ball. And Albus turned back at the right time and an easy interception. That was just perfect. Picture perfect. First and 10 marked at midfield.
Paschal's quarterback has to give his receiver a chance to make a play on the ball.
Trey Brown on first and 10, throws on the run, it's low. And a hard ball to handle for Tyler Wilson, number 17. It'll be second and 10.
Number 15 defending for the Panthers.
Trey Brown got the scoring underway. Less than 4 minutes deep on a 72-yard run. Well, now a flag, or did they not place it right? Incompleted pass, there's no, you put it at midfield, it's second and 10 at the 50.
I'm not sure, maybe the chains were not set.
Could be on the near side where they weren't set properly, but that's an easy call. In tight to the left is Jess Trussell. From the spread on second and 10, running left, 45 to the 41-yard line goes Trey Brown.
Brown on the keeper on the left side.
Close to 9 yards, it'll be third down and short. Offensive line for Martin averages 244. A.J. Brown, Alex Shamshon, Sean Mullen, Brandon Lawson, and Leonard Bradley. And Paschal with a surge.
Nick Smith on the carry.
Smith hit hard.
Jack Clonch on the stop for the Panthers.
No gain. It'll be fourth and one. Jack Clonch there for Paschal. On fourth down, needing a yard at the 41. Hand off and stacked up at the 39. He needed one, he got 2 yards. Number 36, Miles Kelly.
Miles Carey on the
his first gain of the night. First and 10, Martin with 4:07 to go in the half. From the 39. Trey Brown looking towards the Martin sidelines. Nick Smith to the right of Brown. Trey loading up, fires, open receiver at the 32, breaking a tackle, 20, 15, 10, 5, number 17. Tyler Wilson takes it all away, but a flag drop near the 20-yard line.
Touchdown Warriors.
It'll come back.
Maybe a block in the back or a hold on Martin.
Brown able to squeeze it in and get it to Wilson. But this one will come back.
Personal foul, number 84. 15-yard penalty from the spot of the foul.
So some kind of infraction on Ty Dobbins. Here's another look at Brown as Wilson sheds the defender. Thought he had a touchdown. The ball is placed at the 35. And a timeout call with 3:37 to go in the half. Volleyball this weekend at Martin. It'll be the Arlington Lady Colts and the Lady Warriors of Martin. First place or second place on the line, depending what North Crowley does this weekend. And a Martin Bandsman getting some screen time. About 10 seconds of screen time here at AT&T Stadium. From the 35-yard line, it is first down and 6 yards. First and 6 at the 35. Nick Smith cuts it back, 30, 25. Smith, 15, dodges the defender, upset at the 13-yard line. Smith taken down by Jonathan Carrillo, number 12. First and 10, Martin. As Smith starts out to the right, cuts it back. And here's another handoff to Smith coming right. Smith, touchdown. Smith cut down at the goal line, able to cross the double stripe and scores. 13 yards, and Smith, 5 touchdowns tonight and counting.
Paschal has got to get off these blocks and make tackles.
It is 57-7.
Alan Castellina.
And a new kicker, Alan Castellina, a senior. And his extra point is good. Castellina, his first extra point of the year. He's a 6'1", 145-pound senior.
The senior.
And he has an extra point. And with 3:12 to go in the half, it is a 58-7 butt kicking.
I think that's an understatement.
At what point, I mean, you can't not try to score, but it's hard to ease up. And Coach Wager has inserted, you know, some second-teamers already.
Yeah.
It's just Paschal not being able to hold on to the ball or just make anything happen, and not much else you can do.
No.
As Martin set to kick off yet again in the first half. Number 26 dropping back, trying to shield his eyes from the sun, Chris Padrone. That sun shouldn't be a problem for about the next 5 or 6 minutes.
Someone on Paschal has got to get this team fired up and make tackles. The defense cannot keep playing like this.
It's caught at the 5 by Kelly DeRoe. 15, 20. DeRoe goes down at the 21. Ran sideways about 15 yards. First and 10, Panthers. A little over 3 minutes to go in the half. Nine possessions for Paschal. And they have it at the 21. Dylan Thomas, the signal caller. Well, no, he's not. He's going to be used as receiver. And number 4, William Floyd, the quarterback. Floyd trying to get it to Thomas.
Oh.
No flag. The play defended by DeQuaylen Thomas. Well, he has caught touchdown passes this year, Dylan Thomas.
Nearly picked off.
No, both of them going for the ball. Late dive by McEwen. Second and 10 from the 21. On a slant pattern, caught at the 28. Post pattern. And Geiger on the reception. William Floyd to Kalen Geiger. It'll be third down and short. 2:37 clock moving. Third and about 2 yards. Running play and a loss of a yard. Running back double teamed. O'Shea Jackson, one of the two Warriors in there. A little slow to get up as Padron, as he lost a yard. It'll be fourth down and 3 with 2:06 to go in the half. And now Padron going to have to come out. Shaken up on that last tackle. Dylan Thomas still out as a receiver. Fourth down. And here's a screen pass, and Martin is held, and then some. Bradrick McEwen on the tackle. Geiger on the reception. He lost a yard. And the ball goes over. That's the tackle that forced Padron to leave. Martin has it at the Panther 26.
Inside Panther territory at the 26-yard line.
I don't know if I agree with that call for a screen pass on fourth and 3. I think he should have thrown for the first down.
This is the 8th possession for Martin. At the 26, the fake to Nick Smith in traffic and a hard hit. Trey Brown, he's bent back at the 25.
Paschal's defense showing a little life.
Yeah, they are. Nice stick on Brown by Alfredo Flores. Second and 9 with a minute 22 to go in the half. At the 25, dropping back is Brown. He throws to the corner. It is batted away and caught on the deflection. Touchdown, Martin. Christian Levy.
To Christian Levy. Touchdown.
On the deflection. And another Christmas present.
25-yard pass play.
Oh.
Brown to Levy.
Off of the tip of Kelly Giroux. Now Christian is 5'11". And just picked it off. And I'm running out of scoring sheets here. Yeah. I can't keep up with this game.
I think Kelly dusted the ball off before he gave it to him.
Yeah. It is 64-7.
Dead ball offsides.
Encroachment on Paschal.
Looked like it was on Kelly.
Christian Levy, a junior. His third touchdown catch of the year. Watson with a little fake there on the extra point attempt.
Martinez.
Julian Martinez. And his extra point is good off the screen.
Tackle on 61 for the Warriors.
And 7 more points for the Warriors. It is a 65-7 score, a minute 11 to go in the half. And I just wonder, Anthony, at halftime, if Coach Matt Cook may say, hey, let's have a running clock maybe in the second half. Maybe not his decision at all.
No.
Here's the tip at the goal line, and then, hey, Levy, I'll just reach over the top and hold on to it.
Yeah, that's...
Now, would both coaches have to agree to a running clock?
Yes, they both would have to agree to a running clock. But ultimately, it's up to the losing team.
Martin has scored on every possession. They've also had a block punt. .35 points in the second quarter for the Warriors. Came in averaging 42. On the kickoff, it's fielded by Durow. And Durow, as the pursuit catches up at the 23.
Durow on the carry, brought down by number 11.
Jordan Trim downfield, Garrett Bales as well, or Bayless.
Yeah, Matt Cook is going to have his hands full at halftime.
First and 10, Panthers on their own 23-yard line.
At the 23, first and 10 with a minute 5 to go in the half. Quarterback William Floyd. Floyd looking, floats one over the middle. He's got Thomas. Dylan Thomas will catch it and stay on his feet and score. 77 yards.
That was Wayne Floyd out of shotgun.
Where was that play in the first quarter?
Yeah.
Dylan Thomas, touchdown, Panthers.
William Floyd to Thomas. Thomas's fourth touchdown catch
Dylan
of the year.
Thomas.
77 yards, got away from the defender at the 40-yard line, and the junior takes it all away. Six. 78 points combined here in the first half. Extra point attempt by Vasquez is good.
Christian Vasquez is good.
Well, Thomas has thrown for one and has now caught a touchdown pass.
85-yard touchdown play from Floyd to Thomas.
It's not 85 yards, as the PA announcer told the crowd, it's 77. .65 to .14. Second most points offensively for Martin this year. Put 67 on the board against Lamar on September 26th. And the kickoff by Vasquez, taken at the 3-yard line. Crossing the 20, crossing the 25 is Jared Phipps, stacked up at the 31. Jared Phipps. On the kickoff return. About just taking a knee on one snap and in the half. 65-14. Number 17, Tyler Wilson. And the Martin offense, Travis Murray, one of the wideouts. Christian Levy goes wide right. And Wilson going to try to go deep over the middle and overthrows number 17, or rather Brown, to Tyler Wilson. Wilson, the intended receiver.
I'm actually surprised they didn't take a knee on this one.
Second down. And 10.
Yeah, I kind of am also, with just 37 seconds to go in the half and a 51-point lead. Trey Brown on the run, throws, got his tight end at the 48. Jess Trussell at 6'5 and 220. Came in with 15 catches and 290 yards this year. They spot it at the 49, first and 10, with 17 seconds left in the half. Brown overthrows Wilson, had him on the near side. Overthrew him by about 2 feet. Defending number 12, Jonathan Carrillo.
Second down.
11 seconds left in the half.
Maybe Martin's unaware of the scoreboard. I mean, airing it up with 11 seconds.
On top, 65 to 14. Trying to go for more to the near side. Caught and dropped. It's a catch for Levy, and that is the end of the first half.
Pass complete to Levy over the right side. Out the shotgun.
The first half ends on a reception by Christian Levy, and Martin will take a 51-point lead into the locker room. It's halftime at AT&T Stadium. Our score, Martin 65, Paschal 14. John Nelson back with Anthony Hargrove, just about set for half number two. It is all Martin leading 65-14. And Anthony, what a first half for Mr. Brown and Mr. Smith of Martin.
Yeah, Nick Smith has been the workhorse for this offense, Martin offense. First half, he's coming in with 151 yards on 8 carries and 5 touchdowns. Followed by Brown with 97 yards on 4 attempts and 2 touchdowns. Those two, you have to say, they're the total package.
Well, here's the 86-yard run by Nick Smith to put Martin up 14 to nothing, 4:32 to go in the first quarter. Trey Brown, he takes it in, and 2 touchdowns in the first half. Martin led 30 to nothing with 12 seconds to go in the first quarter. Josh Watson will field this one at the 10-yard line on a punt that went awry. That made it 37 to nothing. Nick Smith on a 10-yard run, 44 nothing Martin. And Smith later scored on a yard run. Paschal kicks off to begin the second half. Mark moving from left to right. Kickoff return, Jared Phipps. And Phipps stacked up across the 40-yard line. Martin scored 30 points in the first quarter, 35 in the second. Paschal got on the board on a Thomas 52-yard pass to Geiger. Then Floyd hit Thomas on a 77-yard pass.
First and 10, Warriors.
Martin has it at the 45-yard line as we begin the second half. And we'll check a eye on the clock as Martin has begun to clear the bench. Here's a run up the middle by Terrence Jones, number 35. Jones has yardage to the 48-yard line. Noah Bondront is the new quarterback. Bondront, a senior, Seth Riney in the offensive line, number 72. Brad Martin, number 77. Ty Dobbins, one of the receivers. Second teamers on for Martin to begin the half. Bondurant is a quarterback. On the sweep, this is Dobbins. Dobbins crosses midfield, cuts it back 40. Dobbins 35, and Dobbins drags a defender down to the 30-yard line. Is this an easy game to referee, Anthony, with all the scoring and the big plays, or is it difficult for an official?
With the score being the way it is, this is an easy game, an easier game for the officials. You can get away with letting some holding calls get away from you, and the losing coach won't be that upset because he knows the game is pretty much out of hand.
Bondurant, the third quarterback tonight for Martin. He swings it out to Huntley. Huntley still on his feet, 20, and driven back to the 20. Jason Huntley, a junior, on the reception.
Big Fanning on the stop for the Panthers.
Ball spotted at the 18-yard line. That's where he got to, and it's a Martin first down. Noah came in. One of the two quarterbacks that replaced Eric Walker after he suffered the ankle injury October 3rd at Cravens in the game against Sam Houston. At the 18-yard line, clock is running, and Martin doesn't have a receiver, Travis Murray. There's 10 out there now, and here's the 11th player in with a play, Travis Murray. I mean, the plays are quite, you can call the plays yourself, Anthony, and hand off to the right, hand off to the left.
It's pretty much there either way. The left, right, middle is there.
I mean, you call your own play without assault or other consulting the coaches. A run to the 15-yard line by Bondurant. I think you and I could call the plays the rest of the game for Martin.
Yeah, pretty much.
22 dive right. Quarterback keeper around the left side. A gain of three, second down, seven for Mark from the scrimmage at the Paschal 15-yard line. Colby Pulliam, 83, wide left. Bondurant, the quarterback, he will hand it off. This is Jones. Terrence Jones cuts it back and is tackled at the 12. Matthew Ainsworth, number 98, on the takedown. Miles Kelly had a run in the first half. Terrence Jones now with a couple of carries in the second half for Martin. Third down, four. They have it at the 12. Again, Martin 5-2 overall, leading District 4-6A with a 4-0 record. At the 12, Bondurant turns. Here's the toss, Terrence Jones. Jones to the 11-yard line. Hit first by number 21, Cruz Shelby. Also in on the tackle, number 54, Alfredo Flores. It'll be fourth down and three at the Paschal 11. And Martin is lined up to attempt a 26-yard field goal.
Trey Tuttle, number 92.
Nice little victory for the Paschal defense, holding Martin to a field goal.
Officially, it'll be a 27-yard field goal attempt. And it is good. Number 92, Trey Tuttle, his fifth field goal of the year. Trey Tuttle and Julian Martinez, following a long line of successful marked kickers. Ben Grogan now at Oklahoma State. Jaden Oberkrom at TCU. Spencer Evans kicked last year. And it is now 68-14. And the first possession for Paschal coming up in the second half. Again, they lead the all-time series 11-0. The average score down through the years in the Martin Paschal series has been 47-9 Martin. Alan Castellino will kick off for the Warriors. Castellino has it teed up. Back deep for Paschal, as they have been the entire night. Kelly DeRoe and number 26, Chris Padron. It sails to DeRoe. Fields it at the 11-yard line, looking for some blocking. 15-20, has an open area and cut down at the 24-yard line.
DeRoe on the carry.
Number 30 downfield. Bradrick McEwen.
First down, Panther.
First possession for Paschal in the second half.
Ball spotted right near the 24-yard line.
We had talked about maybe a continuous running clock, Anthony, at halftime, and that option would rest with the Paschal coach, but.
Yeah, it doesn't look like they're.
Not going to happen, at least right now.
No, not right now.
Quarterback is number 4, William Floyd. Floyd empties the backfield, look out, and is leveled. Hit from behind as Floyd goes down.
William Floyd back calling the signals for the Panthers.
It's a loss of 6.
Now bring up second down.
Floyd again empties the backfield. Here's a pass to Hernandez. Hernandez to the 22-yard line. Wrapped up by Brandon Dillard, the quarterback, number 8.
Hernandez on the catch, knocked out by number 9. DeMarcus Powers.
It'll be third down and 12.
See you linebacker. Third down and 11.
Dylan Thomas started tonight. Now it's William Floyd. Oh. He's hit as soon as he throws and almost intercepted at the 42-yard line. Number 25, Brandon Fender, was the nearest.
Kalen Geiger was the intended receiver. Number 25 in on defense.
It'll set up fourth down. In punt formation is Floyd.
It's going to be an offside on Martin.
Thielen at the Martin 45-yard line. This is Trip White. White now runs to the other side. Still hasn't been tackled. Still hasn't gone down. And White all the way down to the 11-yard line.
Takes it near the 50, works his way down deep inside Panther territory, down to the 10-yard line.
Flag on the play.
Flag on the play.
Here's another look at White. The flag dropped about right now at the 20-yard line, chased by Kalen Geiger.
Offside.
Offside, receiving team number 11. 5-yard penalty, repeat fourth down.
By the way, number 96, who has already been on a couple of tackles for Martin, is Uko Isang, number 96. Isang has played now in four games as Bob Wager will play everybody tonight. So we'll do it again. It's fourth and seven. Big rush up the middle, end over end, fielded on the run. This is White. He takes it to the Paschal 37.
Floyd on the punt, White on the reception.
So Martin will have it in Paschal territory at the 37-yard line.
First down, Warriors.
Our first drive resulted in a 27-yard field goal. Noah Marsh in, number 14.
Fan cam, don't get caught napping.
Marsh will be the fourth quarterback tonight. Homecoming activities wrapping up here for the Martin Warriors, and a new homecoming king and queen announced. Well, I'll take it back. Marsh going to be used as a receiver. Bondurant stays in at quarterback. Bondurant will keep it, running behind number 72, Seth Riney, and takes it to the 33. Gain of about 4 yards.
Ulysses Moreno on the stop for the Panthers. Second down.
Martin playing his fifth game all time at AT&T Stadium. Paschal coming off a 75-19 loss last week to Sam Houston. Martin knocking off Bowie 33-21. On second and five, Bondurant. He'll start Huntley in motion. The handoff being tracked and spun down by
Huntley on the carry.
The Paschal defender.
Brought down by Ben Fanning. Senior defensive line on the stop. Brings up the third down.
It'll bring up third and a nickel.
That's going to be offsides.
At the 33, here's another flag. This one is intercepted at the 10-yard line. Pass intended for Marsh. This is Kelly Durow. Durow crosses midfield. Little extracurricular.
That's going to be offsides on Paschal.
Hunter Williamson on the pick.
The initial flag dropped
flag on the play.
Back at the line of scrimmage, and then Durow with a nice pickoff at about the five. You could have two or three penalties on a play like this, Anthony. I'm sure you have called them as well.
Offside. Oh, yeah.
On the defense, 5-yard penalty. We'll leave it to the line to gain. First down.
Yeah, I think both line referees both had offsides on the defense.
Well, it'll cost Paschal. No interception. Martin will hang on to it at the 33. They'll send Pulliam, one of the receivers, to the left. Terrence Jones, a running back. Here's a toss to the 27. Jones hit hard. Eli Scott. And Marino there for Paschal. Good stop by Ulysses Marino, a sophomore. Second down, 8. Noah Bondurant is the QB. Gets the pass from center. He wants to throw. And number 4 wide open at the 5-yard line, Travis Murray. Murray on a post pattern and takes it in. Bondurant dials number 4, Murray. It is now 74-14.
Bondurant to Murray.
Extra point attempt. Julian Martinez, he has knocked home 19 extra points this year. And
well, there are some sportsmanship. They
taking a knee. I like that.
Watson takes the knee on the extra point.
The holder, Josh Watson, drops to a knee, and that terminates
the
extra point attempt. 74-14. Now, the all-time city record for most points in a game is 80. And Martin sets the kickoff with 2:48 to go in the third. At AT&T Stadium with 2:48 to go in period number three. Alan Castellina will kick off for Martin. Paschal this year has given up 76 points to Fort Worth South Hills. Arlington Lamar also scored 76 points. Last week, Sam scored 75, fielded at the 15-yard line. Working his way to the 25. Still on his feet. Number 10 on the return for the Panthers, David Hernandez, the senior. Nowhere to run and nowhere to hide.
Works his way up near the 25-yard
line. Goes down at the 25. The second possession in the half for Paschal. Purple and white of Fort Worth Paschal on Berry Street. They call it Panther Alley near the campus, the football practice field. Drake Dennison, offensive lineman, making sure he has the right play. Here's the quarterback. He guns. It is caught by Hernandez. Hernandez upended at the 32-yard line.
Matthew Cookie. Complete to Hernandez.
Gain of about 8 yards. Have a new quarterback for Paschal. Don't have him on the roster, number 18.
Second down and two.
Second and two. He throws on the run. This is Geiger and drops it.
Nice save by number 18. It was a bad snap, too high.
It'll be third down and two.
Third down and two.
Intended for Geiger at the 40. Maybe shaken up. Roll over pretty hard.
Pass intended for Geiger, incomplete.
And Geiger. They need the medical staff.
Brandon Diller defending for the Warriors.
Holding his left wrist. He's still on the sidelines. As the trainer comes over, it'll be fourth down and two for Paschal with a minute 50 to go in the third. And here's another look at Geiger and the defender from Martin, Brandon Dillard.
He came down on that left wrist.
Rolls over and immediately starts to grab it. Paschal has a Matthew Cook listed as a sophomore quarterback. But that's not the number that he usually wears. Number 18, our third quarterback tonight for Paschal. Cooper Bates is also listed as a quarterback for Paschal.
Hopefully Geiger is okay. Maybe we'll see him back in the game here soon.
It's fourth and two. And Paschal will throw and try to convert. And the pass a little too tall, intended for Hunter Williamson, number six. And the ball goes over on downs with a minute 46 to go in the third.
Pass intended for Matthew Cook.
Offensive line comes to the Paschal ball bench. Big first number 76, place. John Nelson, a junior. He's got to be an outstanding player. Has the smarts. Martin from the Paschal 32-yard line. Number five, Noah Bondrant. He'll hand it off over the left side, and Terrence Jones is hit up high and driven back by Marino.
This is Marino in on the stop for the Panthers. No gain on the play.
Second. And a dime.
And 10.
Martin will, in the regular season, as they take on North Crowley at Cravens Field, November the 6th. Next week, they'll play on Halloween night against Arlington. Here's the pitch headed towards the sidelines. Martin trying to get to it first. I believe they did. Noah Marsh, number 14.
Off the pitch, fumbled out of bounds.
Bondrant on the option. And
Warriors.
Terrence Jones couldn't hold on to it. I mean, it was catchable, it was high, but you got to grab that one.
Yeah, Marino, I think Marino disrupted that pad, that toss. He's been in on a lot of plays here.
Third down and 10.
Third and 10. Clock moving, 20 seconds to go in the quarter. On third and long, Bondrant. Play action, looking, reverses, and dragged down at the 35. A loss of a couple will be fourth and 12, and that is a third. We played three. On to the fourth quarter here at AT&T Stadium. Martin leading Paschal 74-14. Martin has it to begin the fourth quarter at the Paschal 34-yard line. It's fourth and 12. And a 51-yard field goal attempt is going to be well short. Martin trying to connect from 51 yards out. Trey Tuttle, his longest this year is 46.
Field goal attempt.
And the missed field goal. You can always say, yeah, nailed one at AT&T from 51 yards. And during the warm-ups, again, both he and Martinez were hitting from 45 rather easily. The wind will never be a factor here. The sunlight, I mean, that's not that big a deal, but
number three, Geiger, looks like he's okay, and that's their leading rusher. He comes in with 91 yards receiving on seven catches.
Paschal takes over at the 34 and a pass to the 42-yard line. And the man we just talked about, Kalen Geiger. On the year, that's Geiger's 35th catch. He's gone over 500 yards in receiving.
Second down and
He's had a nice season, the sophomore. He and Thomas will both be back. Geiger caught a 52-yard toss from Thomas in the second quarter. This is a little high. It's pulled down by Geiger. Takes a hit, but able to keep moving and stay in bounds.
Pass complete to Geiger. Number 57, Austin Crater, in on the stop.
Austin Crater, a senior, on the tackle. Here's a high ball and then the missed tackle. Now the other way. Hernandez crosses midfield.
Pass complete to Hernandez.
It's a gain of seven. It'll be second down three. Martin leading by, that is right, 60 big ones.
Secondary.
William Floyd.
And three.
He'll hand off running room to the right side, and the door closed quickly. Chris Padron is punished. Crater on the stop. Number 36 got to him first, Miles Kelly. It is a Panther first down with 10 to go in the game. And really, in essence, Anthony, a running clock.
Yeah, I guess the Paschal coach decided to go ahead and say, hey, look, this one's over, guys.
Padron, it's caught, it's a touchdown. Nice pass and a nice catch. Hunter Williamson, his third touchdown catch of the year. Number four, William Floyd. And in full stride, hits Hunter Williamson. So the Panthers, at least one more time before tonight's over, can play their fight song.
Yeah.
All of the Panther touchdowns tonight have been via the pass. Christian Vasquez, a senior out of the hold of William Floyd. Will try to make it 74-21.
Enforcement will be only kickoff, 15 yards.
Most points for a Martin team. They put 66 on the scoreboard against Paschal last year at Cravens. And some motion in the line. What did Nick Smith finish tonight rushing wise? 151 yards.
That's 151 yards on eight carries.
Almost 19 yards a carry. So the penalty. And Hernandez will try to convert, Vasquez will convert his 18th.
It's going to be an encroachment on Martin.
No reason to throw the flag on that, Anthony. I mean, extra points, good. Let's go with that. Nobody would complain at all.
No, I don't think so.
74-21, extra point. Is good by Vasquez.
Floyd to Williamson on the pass play. That's a 15-yard touchdown.
And Paschal set to kick off. All penalties will be declined for the rest of the night.
That penalty was just to let the coaches know, hey, look, I'm still awake. I'm still here. You know.
Yeah, as much as you'd like to. other than the obvious. I mean, if you have a hole that's away from the ball, there's no right. reason to reach into the pocket and throw the flag.
Not with the score like it is, no.
A homecoming win tonight for Martin. They'll go to a perfect 5-0 in district and remain in first place. 6-2 overall. And for the third time, they'll have a second, have a 5-0 district start. A 5-0 district start for the second time in 3 years. And here's the Paschal Panther kickoff. Fielded at the 20-yard line. On the return, this is Huntley. 30, 35, 40. Crosses midfield. Huntley breaks a tackle. Huntley to the 30. He may go, and he does. He goes coast to coast. Jason Huntley.
Jason Huntley.
And this ties the all-time city record for the most points ever by an Arlington team. 80 yards on the kickoff return. Huntley the junior right here has an avenue, breaks one. Number 13 trying to get the angle on him. And takes it all the way. It is 80-21. And we'll see if Watson again drops to a knee. Yeah, he does.
Watson takes a knee on the extra point attempt.
Ties the city record on the kickoff return by Jason Huntley, a 5'8", 160-pound junior. All the Martin faithful have remained. Martin alums from years past on hand this homecoming night. There's a Trip White fan, number 12. And one of the larger homecoming moms we've seen. And not to be outdone, Paschal wants to let everybody know that they are here as well. Senior Alan Castellina set to kick off. And this one sails out of bounds. It was caught and dropped at the 12 by Kelly DeRoe.
He should have let that one go.
That would have brought it out to the 30. So Paschal has it at their own 12-yard line with 9:31 to go in the game. And not much you can do here. You can start that clock and let it go.
Yeah.
third quarterback for Paschal. He comes out throwing. It's a low ball. It is ruled a no catch. That is Matthew Cook, number 18. Pass intended for David Hernandez. Cook's a sophomore. Second. And 10 trips to the left. Chris Padron, the setback. Matthew Cook, son of the head coach, throws on the run, caught at the 15. A couple of more yards for Kalen Geiger.
Geiger on the reception.
Geiger has 10 catches tonight. It's a gain of 5, third and 5. Paschal will fall to 2-6 on the year, 1-4 in the district. Another catch by Geiger, forced out of bounds by Nick Hamilton, number 13. He'll be about a couple of yards short. Also in pursuit for Martin. Malik Neely, number 54. It's fourth and a long two here. Clock moving, 8:27 to play. A catch and a drop at the 20 by Hernandez, and the ball goes over. Martin and Paschal, six different stadiums they have played, and Martin will have won all of them.
Panthers turnover.
Quite a difference between Scarborough Hanley Field and AT&T Stadium. They played a game there once. It was 3 years ago. In Hanley at that little quaint neighborhood stadium, 48-10. Was the outcome. Mark takes over at the Paschal 19. And a handoff on the sweep. Pulliam breaks a tackle. And Pulliam trying to get to the pylon and does. And that sets the all-time city record.
Number 83 on
the Colby
Pulliam.
19 yards. On the handoff, most points ever scored by a city team. It is 86-21. And should stay 86-21, and it does. And we break with 7:59 to go. In the contest, Martin on top, 86-21. John Nelson back with Anthony Hargrove at AT&T Stadium awaiting the Martin kickoff. Really no drama, just booted away and stay in bounds. This one angled and caught at the 23-yard line by Gil Lee, and Lee dropped. Jordan Trim downfield for Martin, number 11, breaking through a couple of defenders.
First and 10, Panthers.
The fifth possession in the second half for Paschal.
7:50 left in the ball game.
The night started with a Trey Brown 72-yard run. Nick Smith followed that up with an 86-yard burn. Matthew Cook, the signal caller. He turns and hands it off to the 29-yard line. Chris Padron, a junior, one of 20 on the squad. A Gain of five. They spot it right on the 30. They'll give him the 30. Sean Collier on the D line for Martin. Another run for Padron. First down yardage 40. 45 yard line. 15 yards on that carry.
Gain of 12 on the play. First down, Panthers. Brandon Dillon on the stop for the Warriors with the shoestring tackle.
From the 46 with 6:51 to play. First and 10, Paschal. Here's a handoff right side. Crossing midfield, more yardage, 40-yard line to the Martin 35.
Out of the shotgun, Patrick on the carry, works his way inside.
The drone on another carry. Territory. Nick Hamilton on the tackle for Martin. The drone able to get away from Neely, number 54. Brandon Fender caught up with him, number 25.
Brandon Fender on the stop for the Warriors. 6:22 left in the ballgame.
From the 35, first and 10, Paschal. Cook throws and intended at the 20-yard line for Geiger.
Nick Hamilton on the stop.
Nick Hamilton defending for Martin.
Second down.
Clock moving. Exactly 6 minutes to play. Padron angles over the left side. Can't get away from anybody. No gain at all. With a third down and needing 10, Dylan Thomas started. William Floyd also played quarterback tonight. And now Matthew Cook.
And 10.
From the Warrior 35. Cook fires and a little low intended for Hernandez at the 25-yard line. It'll be fourth down.
He had his guy, but he just underthrew him.
Yeah, the right play, and Hernandez was able to get open. Martin having knocked off Bowie last week, 33-21. And numbers-wise, a huge city record-setting night tonight. Cook scrambles, lobs one out of bounds. Intended for Geiger.
Cook flushed out to his left. Pass intended for Geiger.
And with exactly 5 minutes to play, Martin takes over.
Warriors will take over. 5 minutes left in the ball game, folks.
Don't forget, we'll have the 8th grade city championship on November the 4th. Cravens Field is the site this year for the runner-up and the championship game. Nick Noah Bondrant and the running back Terrence Jones. This is Jones. Drags a couple of tacklers with him out to the 45-yard line. Crisscross handoff to Terrence Jones. And he moved the pile all the way out to the 45. First and 10, Martin. 4.5 minutes to play. Shuttling players in and out. Tristan Lutz, number 42, will get in some action tonight. Handoff and a gain of three for Jones over the left side. Or Kelly it is, Miles Kelly. Uniforms tonight, Anthony, it's Oakland against Kansas State. The Raiders and the Wildcats. Paschal isn't that far away except for the design on the helmet for the Cowboys home units. You put the star and it's Dallas's home uniforms. He'll keep it, Bondurant, inside the 45.
Bondurant on the keeper.
At one time, Martin had all white helmets. They had the big red rocking in. Then they went back to silver. Then they changed again.
On the stop for the Panthers. First and 10 Warriors inside.
Ball spotted at the Paschal 44-yard line. Time for about three more plays.
3 minutes left in this football game, folks.
Another keeper cutting it back against the float, taking it to the 35-yard line.
Is
Bondurant.
Works it up the middle.
Gain of close to 10. Inside of 2.5 minutes. Second down and about a half a yard. That 86 points eclipses the all-time score that Arlington pile up against a Hanley team some 85 years ago, I believe. From the 35 with 2 minutes to play and plunging straight ahead and collecting the first down is Bondurant. So Martin will set its sights on Arlington High Halloween night at UTA's Maverick Stadium. Frightening tonight enough. Halloween came early for Paschal. Man. Brian Ramirez inserted in the D line, number 57.
I think Martin's setting up to take a couple of knees here and head on out.
Well, it's bunched up into a victory formation in all essence. I mean, one more time and that'll do it.
That should do it.
Paschal trying to get in some more players as well before the end of the night. Panthers scored 14 in the second quarter. And a touchdown here in the fourth. A Williamson 21-yard reception.
He got some big numbers from Geiger tonight. He had 110 yards receiving, one touchdown. Pretty good numbers.
Padron, 9 carries and 90 yards of rushing. And that will be the last play of the night as the coaches and the players will meet at midfield. AISD-TV on hand for our first ever telecast from AT&T Stadium. And Martin wins big as Bob Wager collects win number 130. It ended early tonight. In the first quarter, as Martin scored 30 in the first 12 minutes.
And at the buzzer, folks.
Our final score, the Martin Warriors on homecoming defeat Paschal 86-21. Nice job by our AISD-TV crew located right here on the 30-yard line at AT&T Stadium. There's our crew. For Anthony and everyone else, our final score once again, Martin 86, Paschal 21. This is John Nelson saying good night from AT&T Stadium in Arlington.